Chris Biandi on the track.
So that's one of the many clips of professional saxophonist Ariana Stanberry that's been making its way on social media. She's admired by many and has worked alongside Grammy nominee Tia Fuller. She joins us now via Zoom to talk about her journey. And I kind of feel she's a little bit show off because she just make that look so easy. And it looked to be the most difficult instrument in life. Ariana, morning, welcome. How are you?
Good morning. I'm good. Thank you. How are you?
I can't complain. Give thanks. So that you don't show off on us with your saxophonist, saxophone. Great to meet you. Tell me about the journey from here to where you are now. When did you leave us and why did you leave us?
Sure. So I moved to the United States in the year of 2004. I was 6 years old and I kind of was told by my parents that, you know, we came here for just more opportunity for me and my sisters. And I've just been really grateful and privileged to be able to have access to all the music education here. I currently reside in Connecticut, United States, and I've been here for about 16 or 17 years now.
Oh, fantastic. Why music and why the saxophone? It seems to be the most difficult. I don't know if it are the trombone, but the two of them just look incredibly difficult. So where did the music thing come from in the first place?
So I actually grew up in a very musical family. Everyone in my family, even my extended family, are musicians, including my father and my mom. So while we were in Jamaica, I went to Portmore Missionary Prep School as well as Portmore Missionary Church, and my dad was very involved with the music ministry there. So I kind of was raised already in just a very musical household, a musical church, and that was kind of the start of my musical journey, I would say. I chose the saxophone at the age of 9 after I already came here to the United States because my mom said it was her favorite instrument. And ever since starting, I really fell in love with the tone and the timbre of the saxophone. It's a really unique sound and I really love it.
Yep. You sing also, don't you?
I do.
Which one you prefer, the singing or the playing of the saxophone?
Actually, I think I would have to say the saxophone, only because I feel like I'm a bit more challenged. That singing has always kind of come natural to me.
Yeah.
So I would pick the saxophone.
How long did it take you to be competent? Well, you're obviously an expert now, but how long did it take you to be just competent?
That's a good question. I would say that I started to become more of a developed saxophonist in my high school years. That's when I started to take it really seriously. And my band director at the time, Andrew Lefebvre, he really pushed me to be the best version of myself at that point. So I would definitely say around high school. However, you know, I'm still learning and being a musician is never, there's never a point where you can say like you've mastered the instrument. I feel like playing the saxophone is kind of a lifelong journey and being good at it is something that is also a lifelong.
Yeah, I can imagine. So you studied professional music with focuses on music performance. I understand that. Music production. I understand that. What's music education? What's that?
Sure. So that really just focuses on being able to teach kids, teenagers, adults, you know, musicians of all ages, the basics of music theory, as well as teaching them, you know, how to be efficient on their select instrument. For me, I typically focus on the saxophone itself. I used to teach beginner piano lessons as well, but right now my main focus is just being able to teach the alto saxophone.
Right. Ariana aspires to pave a way for young Black women in the woodwind music world by advocating for women's rights and equality through her artistry and her music or musicianship. Oh, talk to me about that. How are you going to deal with that?
Sure. So growing up in Connecticut, I live in Mystic, Connecticut, and so the area is a predominantly white city and town. So being raised in music education in general, it's been a predominantly white space. And I haven't necessarily seen that much representation when it comes to seeing Black women in these spaces, especially in the woodwind field. There are very few like professional Black women alto saxophonists. And so since I have the privilege of being able to meet so many people in my field and network in not just the music industry, but in the woodwind world, it's really just a dream come true for me to continue to pave the way for upcoming young Black women artists so that they can feel like they are able to succeed in this industry without feeling like they're underrepresented.
Is it the same thing if you are, a soloist, which we just saw something from you, or if you play in a band? Do you play in a band? And does it matter whether you're in the band? Because I noticed it said that you played on some albums. Tell me some of the folks who you've worked with, but do you play in a band or you're just a soloist?
Yeah, I do a little bit of everything. Actually, in high school, when I started to take the saxophone seriously, I was very involved in the marching band, as well as the jazz band, the concert band. So I dabbled in almost every genre. And then in college, I formed my own band, which I was able to record 3 singles with them, as well as being able to perform in other bands throughout my college experience. And right now I've kind of been doing my own thing with the soloist saxophone. That's kind of been my journey right now, but I also play alongside other artists as well as sit in with other bands whenever I get the opportunity to.
Okay, it says you're a well-rounded jazz and gospel alto saxophonist. That's all you do? Why jazz, why gospel, nothing more?
So I actually believe that any genre, but I chose jazz and gospel because those happen to be my favorite two genres. But I think right now I've been really interested in Afrobeats and reggae and dancehall. So I might broaden that title a little bit. But yeah, the reason why I wrote jazz and gospel is because those are my two favorite genres.
You have the saxophone beside you?
I don't. I left it upstairs.
Ariana, man. I was going to ask you to play us something, but we saw something before and we'll play something at the end of it. It is so good to see you. So great to meet you. Where do you want to go with this? Is this what you're going to do for the rest of your life, or this is right now just filling a little gap? Where do you want to go with this?
Right now, I see myself taking this seriously. About a year ago, I would have said my biggest goal is to get on tour with a huge artist. But unfortunately, due to COVID, that kind of shifted my dreams a little bit. But right now, my goal is really to be able to be successful in this field and be financially stable while doing what I really love, which is making music and collaborating with other musicians. So yeah. I would definitely say where I want to take this is as far as I can take it. And I'm not going to set a limit for myself. I'm just going to keep creating and networking and see how far I can go in the industry.
You might not know this, but you're now on the number one morning program in the history of the world, in the entire world. And you're seen all across the world. Fantastic again to meet you. Anyone you want to say hi to? Do you remember anyone in Jamaica? You left here when you were 6. You remember anything about Jamaica?
Absolutely. I'll say hi to my family at Portmore Missionary. I love you all. Shout out to my god sister Justine, Uncle Steven, and my friends, my Jamaican musician friends, Chavo, Jonathan Foga, Joe Davis, Mikey Music, all of you guys, much love to you. And just continue to do you, because the music world is waiting for someone just like you.
Yeah, man, I love you. Stay safe. God bless you.
Thank you.
Ariana Stanberry, professional saxophonist. Hear a little bit more from her. Thank you. Seems so effortless. By the way, coming up next, a blast from the past. Savory breakfast. What is that? A crepe? With Leon. We'll be right back.